Everybody, Andrew here from AirDev with an episode of Demystifying Tech. Every episode we take one topic or term from tech or software. It might be a little bit challenging, you've probably heard it before, but are afraid to ask your friends what it means. We try to explain it in as simple terms as humanly possible. So today we're going to talk about APIs. API stands for Application Programmable Interface. It's a mouthful, but it's actually a pretty cool topic. So APIs have exploded in the past few years. They're used for all sorts of tools. You've probably heard of them. You've probably used the word in a sentence more than once. But we're going to talk about what APIs are, why they're so cool, and even give you a chance to try them out yourself. So what is an API? The key word in API is the I, interface. An API is an interface, which is basically just an agreed upon language or way to communicate between two things. In this case, it's two pieces of software talking to one another to help out. So if we look at some other examples of interfaces, a plug and a socket, that's an interface. We've decided what shape these little sockets should be so that you can plug in any new device that you get and get power to it. Another one is human language. So rather than having to figure out some agreed upon way to talk to one another, you've got languages, you pick one, you learn it, and you talk to other people. APIs are no different. It's just an interface. So why should you care about APIs specifically? The cool thing about APIs is they make any application a lot easier to do because you can focus on what you're uniquely doing, and you can allow other people who have solved all sorts of other peripheral problems to do what they do best. And you just talk to one another and they'll help you out. So for example, if you have your super secret app and you're looking to have your users pay for things using their credit card, or sign up for your mailing list, or communicate with you so that you get notifications, or authenticate and verify who they are, you can use these existing services to do the trick. So you would talk to a service called Stripe to do your payments, talk to MailChimp to do your email, talk to Slack to send you notifications, and talk to Facebook so that they can say, this is who I am. And by leveraging all these tools, you don't have to do all that work yourself. You don't have to reinvent the wheel. Just leverage your friends. So how does it work in a nutshell? An API, or the interface, is all about a certain language. So there's an agreed upon set of code language where you can send inputs to this third-party service, in this case it's Stripe for payments. And then you can get outputs or responses back from the API. And so let's say you had somebody on your site who wanted to pay for something. You would send a few different parameters of information to Stripe. You would say, here's how much they should be paying, here's their credit card information, their security code, etc. And Stripe would say, thank you very much, we know what to do with this, the gear is returned. And then they would process the payment using the credit card. And they would send you a couple outputs just so that you knew what happened. So they would send you a confirmation code of this transaction and a status. Did it go through? Did the card bounce, etc.? So by leveraging this input and output with Stripe, you don't have to build this very complicated and unsecure credit card payments through your software. You can just leverage Stripe. So hopefully you're very interested in trying APIs out for yourself. How do you do it? So we've got two different things you can try out. You really should test this out. This is a little baby, so this is the entry level way to test it out. There's a really awesome tool called Zapier. It basically allows you to do all sorts of API tasks without writing a line of code. So if you go to zapier.com, they have, this is just a sample that you can try out, they have a connection to Gmail and a connection to Slack. So you can set up a call so that when you receive an email, maybe from a certain special someone, it triggers Slack and sends you a Slack message so that you respond right away. So that's something you can set up by yourself. If you're a little bit more adventurous, we actually wrote a little tutorial that you can find at bit.ly/hotdog or not. And this actually connects a tool called Bubble, which we use a lot to build our applications, with a really nifty AI tool called Watson. This is made by IBM, very popular. And you can actually create a mini application where you can upload an image and it'll tell you if it's a hot dog or not a hot dog based on just reading your unique image. So really cool stuff that you can try out at home. We hope this tutorial has been really helpful for you. If you're interested in learning more, you can go to airdev.co/blog for some of our other pieces, or you can go to airdev.co and start a project tomorrow. Back next time.